What's up? Trying desperately to like a tobacco that you do not particularly enjoy is silly. Giving it yet another chance, trying it in a different vibe. Season, bearing it with something different. It's a waste of time, especially if you've got like few dozen excellent blends that you know for sure will give you a good smoke anytime. It's the same with pipes. An okay pipe, which performs the way you want it only with certain blends, only with certain cuts. Only packed in a particular way. That's not how I do it. Giving chances. No. This is a pipe I trust. Every smoke is perfect. Does not get heated. The draw is just the right resistance. No need of passing pipe cleaner 50 times during the smoke. No relight every 3 puffs. Cool smoke. Comfortable. Looks great. Why would I smoke my other Dunhill, the corncob one? Or this beast, the ultimate smoking tool. Same, only Peterson. Never fails. And I can drop it Or that one. What can I tell you about this one? You can see it's a spigot system. It is awfully made. Nothing is symmetrical. There is a little gap even here where the spigot goes into the tunnel. But it's tight. The drilling is so off-centered. I don't even know how is it possible to drill it so wonky. It's practically on 45. The thickness of the ball is all over the place. Yet, it cannot smoke any better. No pipe on earth can smoke better than that. Equal to that, like this. Or like that. Yes. But not better. Not for any money. There are inclusions, pits in the finish. It doesn't matter. Most of my pipes are like that. Some of them are better looking than other. But they smoke just fine. Except for a few that require chances. No chances from me. I've got the Revel block. You can't have a bad smoke with Revel block. But if you put it in a pipe that needs chances, you might get an average smoke. Not here. So that's my take on giving chances to pipes and tobaccos. Resist the bullshit. Goodbye.